Good morning, everybody, or good afternoon or evening, whenever you're watching this. I know a lot of you are watching it live as we're on YouTube, but a lot of you catch up as well. So welcome to you. Thank you for joining us today. We're going to go straight into some time of worship, and Israel is going to be leading us today with the rest of the band there. As we go in, I just want to encourage all of us, how about we take a moment to think about something that God has done in our lives in the recent days. Even though we're in lockdown, even though there's a lot of hard things happening around us, a lot of uncertainty around us, God is still on the throne and He's still moving and He's still answering prayers and doing wonderful things. So while we might be so busy with other things that are happening around us, let's just take a moment to think about the good things that He's doing right now, even in these days. So just take a moment, just praise God, thank Him for that. And I'm going to pray. Psalm 66 says, you know, shout joyful praises to God, all the earth, sing about the glory of His name. Tell the world how glorious He is. Say to God, how awesome are your deeds. Your enemies cringe before your mighty power. Everything on earth will worship you. They will sing your praises, shouting your name in glorious songs. So, Jesus, we thank you for who you are. Father, we thank you for your love. We thank you, Lord, that we are part of a beautiful family that you welcomed us in with arms wide open. And Father, today we pray that you would send your Holy Spirit. Fill us up one more time. Fill us up with your love, Father. God, we pray that as we worship you, as we praise you, Lord, as we bow before you and humble ourselves before the throne in heaven, God, we pray that you draw us close to you, that you draw close to us. And Father, we give you praise today. We lift the name of Jesus high. And God, as we go into this time of worship, I pray that you would touch our hearts today. You would heal our hearts today. You touch every single person who's been listening in today. Father, we pray that your Spirit move in our midst. And God, that we would make space for your Holy Spirit to move, for you to move, for you to touch our hearts and do the wonderful, mighty miracles that you are still doing even in this day. We praise you. We glorify your name, Jesus. Amen.
Fighting voices in my mind that say I'm not enough. Every single lie that tells me I will never measure. Am I more than just a sum of every high? Every low. strong when I think I'm weak. You say I'm held when I am falling short. When I don't belong, oh, you say I'm yours. And I believe, oh, I believe what you say. Just how beautiful you are and how great you are. redemption by the grace in his eyes. If grace is an ocean, we're all sinking. So heaven meets earth like an unforeseen kiss. My heart turns violently inside my chest. I don't. Bye.
His name is love.
His name is love. His name is love. His name is love. His name is love. His name is love. His name is love. His name is love. His name is love. Emmanuel. Emmanuel, Emmanuel, O God with us, God with us, God with us, God with us. His name is love, His name is love, His name is love. We love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. We speak your name. We speak your name. We speak your name. Thank you.
Thank you, Ezra, for leading us in worship. We have Paul today preaching to us from a very interesting location. So over to Paul, and I hope this word encourages you and builds you up.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to what used to be home for over 20 years for the Prayer House family. And when we came to this place, it had been empty and for a number of years, and we rented it from National Grid for all of those years, and it became home, and we saw many people married, and we had funerals here, and we had parties and celebrations. We baptized people, we celebrated birthdays, anniversaries, and we worshiped God, and we prayed our heads off in this place, and we wept and fasted, prayed through the night, prayed through the day. And this place really has become the kind of cradle, if you like, that where the Prayer House family really found our identity and found our kind of niche in the town of Weymouth. And then, as most of you know, back a little over a year ago, the place was burned by an arson attack. And last week we heard from National Grid to say that we needed to pack up everything that was still out and clear it all up because they're going to start demolition. Well, they've really kindly let us operate Soul Food from over there in that corner for the past year and a bit. And we've really enjoyed favour from National Grid and the agents that work for them. So we're really, really grateful. As you know, we've been meeting in temporary accommodation and we've been working in a crowded office, and then suddenly comes coronavirus with another set of challenges, and we're all trying to work from home and meet by Zoom and WhatsApp. And so these have been a real kind of challenging time for us as a church. And I know for some, just missing being together is huge, huge pain. And this morning, we met here with a few people who were able to come, and we worshiped God, and it was just like the old times, and the heavens were open above us, and we just began to enjoy the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit again. And although people were socially distant, there was that glorious sense of the people of God doing what we're called to do. And really, I thought it would be helpful for us to have a bit of a take stock. And number one, we want to thank God for all the incredible things that He did with us and through us while we were here, for all of those years. And we also need to be able to, in a sense, draw a line under that time and say, we do not hanker after the old times or live in the past, but we live now, in the present, walking with Jesus day by day with an expectation of incredible things in the future. Now, I believe, and we believe as a church, that our best days are still to come, and we can celebrate the past, but we also live on and live for now and live for the future. So what becomes of this place? Well, as I said, we were told that we had to clear all our stuff out. And I'd just like to tell you a little story because it's a really, really beautiful illustration of the ministry that the church family here has been able to give to the town over the years. So we have a big shipping container over in that corner. We have a mobile exhibition trailer, which is broken, which we've been using prior to lockdown for the guys to sit in and eat their food out of the weather and keep dry, and we had tables in there. We have the old kitchen over there, which also all of these things needed to be removed from the site, and they have a limited scrap value because it's not just aluminium, but it's a whole host of other materials, and it's kind of quite a labor intensive job to get any decent recyclable material from them to make it worth a scrap dealer's while. So anyway, I called a guy and he called his dad, and his dad came to meet me here this morning. And when I arrived, he was talking to Wendy, who was here for Soul Food. And it turns out they knew each other. And I said, oh, you guys know each other. And he says, yeah, she was the first person to feed me a meal when I came out of prison 10 years ago. And so this guy grew up as a traveler among in London, very rough background, fighting and getting into trouble and all kinds of things. And when he came out of prison, he decided to move to this area, and he was living in his van, and he turned up at Soul Food and Wendy fed him. He said, she fed me for weeks. She gave me clothes. She let me have a shower. She let me wash my stuff. And Wendy and Soul Food gave this guy a chance and a hope and a future. And then, so he comes in today to give me a price to remove the things that, for me to organize. Oh, I was thinking it was going to be a lot of money. And any case, he said, this is how much it will cost you. And he told me a figure, and I looked at him and I almost cried. I said, are you serious? Is that enough? I'm sure he doesn't get many customers who say, is that enough? And he says, yeah, of course. I'm not going to charge you any more than it would than I'm going to get for it after all this lady has done for me. And so I want to just, that is just one little example of favor that comes when we sow in righteousness and when we sow in generosity and we sow in integrity in a time of need, when literally we had 3 or 4 days to get this whole thing clear. And I'm thinking, I don't know how we're going to do it in the time. In comes a guy who has been blessed by our ministry all those years before, and then now is in a position to return that blessing. And I tell you what, I was so excited, because particularly I was sharing with the Saunterers this morning as I've been going through the Psalms, and we were on Psalm 112. And let me just read it to you. It says, blessed is the man who fears the Lord, who greatly delights in his commandments. His offspring will be mighty in the land. The generation of the upright will be blessed. Wealth and riches are in his house, and his righteousness endures forever. Light dawns in the darkness for the upright. He is gracious, merciful, and righteous. Listen to this. It is well with the man or woman. We're not going to be sexist. It's well with the man who deals generously and lends, who conducts his affairs with justice. For the righteous will never be moved. He will be remembered forever. He is not afraid of bad news. His heart is firm, trusting in the Lord. His heart is steady. He will not be afraid until he looks in triumph on his adversaries. He has distributed freely. He has given to the poor. His righteousness endures forever. His horn is exalted in honor. The wicked man sees it and is angry. He gnashes his teeth and melts away. The desire of the wicked will perish. But here's the point. We believe that God wants to build a beautiful house and is in the process of doing that in the hearts and lives of the people that are the Prayer House family. And God, that's why we're so concerned with certain values and certain core things that really are really, really important to us. And they're more important to us than a building. It's more important that the values live in the hearts of our people than that we get to come and worship in a nice, comfortable building. However, I also believe that God wants us to have a home. And many of us have come to faith, or at least to have the faith that God wants to give us at least some of this land here. And we may have to pay for it. It may be a purchase thing like Abraham did in Mamre to buy a tomb for his wife when she died. But one way or the other, we believe that God wants us to occupy some space here, some physical space here, and that that house will be a beautiful house as well. But the thing that will make it beautiful is not its architecture in the end, and it's not its facilities and well-designed auditorium and comfy chairs that will make it beautiful. In the end, it's the reputation and the values that come out of that house that make it beautiful. And I just want to pick up this one again. It is well with the man who deals generously and lends, who conducts his affair with justice, his affairs with justice. And we want that to be the way the Prayer House family operate in this town, the way we have operated, the way we tried to operate. and we want to be generous and lend and have resources to share with people. Verse 3 says, wealth and riches are in his house, and his righteousness endures forever. And I was just saying this morning that when I was a young adult, I knew that in my dad's house, my mum and dad's house, were resources that I could go back and help myself to, if you like, without really having to spend a long time asking. I would just say, Dad, can I come and use the welder? Can I use some tools? And or can I borrow the Land Rover because I got to pull a car? And Dad would just be willing to let his resources become my resources. And now I'm a dad. My resources are available to my children and my friends. And my tools and my stuff and my home and my car and these kinds of things I'm able to share and bless people with. And I believe that God wants to establish a ministry hub here that does precisely that. It has wealth and riches to share with the community around, with its sons and daughters, and with the nations of the earth. I believe that God wants to spill out of Weymouth and spill out of this beautiful house, sons and daughters who will go around just living like Jesus, being like Jesus in their neighborhood and in their street and in their place of work. And so my vision for this place is that we will continue. We'll have to have a time away from it while they remediate the land and do what's necessary. We probably should begin to gather some money together. So if anyone would like to give to that, you can email us admin@prayerhouse.uk and we'll give you the details of the building fund, which we do have, which has been a little bit dormant. And let's begin to build our faith up and press in again to God and say, come on then, Lord, let's see the beautiful house made beautiful with beautiful lives that demonstrate your values in this earth, but also a beautiful place that we can invite people into and we can share what we have with them and we can resource the community around us and resource the work of God around the earth. So there you go, guys. It's farewell to a chapter, but it's the opening of another chapter. And thank you to Forty and Sam for filming us here today.
Thank you, Paul, for that word. As Paul said, we are excited about the upcoming season, the next season coming up. So do continue to pray. Like Paul said, we need wisdom. We need God's guidance. We want to know what He has in store for us as a church, as a community. And we want to continue to be that blessing that we've always been to Weymouth and Portland and all the nations around us as well. So continue to pray for us, continue to pray for the leadership and for wisdom as we have discussions and conversations about where our next step is going to be and what it's going to be. So thank you, Paul. Do continue to pray for us. Quick refresher to our minds about what's happening throughout the week. Many of you already know, but for those of you who might be watching it for the first time, or maybe you need just a little reminder, we're going to continue to have Day Shift on Mondays. Watch it on Facebook or YouTube. And last week we had a beautiful, beautiful time. The Spirit was upon us, everybody watching, everybody part of the meeting. And, you know, there was prophetic words coming out, lots of singing and praising, great praying going on. We love seeing those comments on Facebook and on YouTube. And we love that interaction going on. So Facebook and YouTube, 10 o'clock on Mondays, we'll have Day Shift. So do join us. And on Tuesdays, we have Pete's Bible Study at 10 a.m. If you want a link to the Zoom call, please email Pete@prayerhouse.uk and Pete will be able to send you a link. A very, very beautiful, great, informative study that's happening on Tuesdays. We also have Prayer House Kids meeting up on Thursdays. Last week, we had a new family who are not part of our church join in, and it was great It's great to have the young children getting together, play some games, thinking together, and just have that time of fellowship together. So if you are a parent, please contact again Pete on that same email address, or you can also look up Prayer House Parents on Facebook. It's a group that you can join, but there's lots of information and links that we share throughout the week. So look it up. And if you have young children, primary school age in particular, we encourage you to take part in those things. We also, again, have life groups, Zoom socials, all of those things happening, Havering Bible Studies led by Kira. And if you are someone who is feeling that, you know, this whole time you've felt distant and it's been hard for you and you just love some time of fellowship, a time that you spend with other people, we're doing a lot of these things over Zoom. And if you'd like more information, please contact Kira on the email kira@prayerhouse.uk, and she'll be able to help you find what suits you best, and we'll maybe hopefully see you in one of those groups. So that's what's happening throughout the week. Also, just want to take a moment to, like I said, God is still doing beautiful and great and wonderful things. And I'll just take a moment to thank every single one of you who have been giving to the Prayer House. And, you know, we love that and we are so grateful for that. And it is part of our worship, and that is one of the main reasons why we do it and we encourage others to do it. It's because when we give something that's ours to God, it's an act of worship. It costs us something. You know, David said, God, I don't want to give you something that didn't cost me anything. And so when we give away a bit of our money, it means that we're making ourselves weak in that area, because in a way we're saying to God, God, I don't trust the paycheck that comes in. I don't trust the money that I get from my pensions or whatever way you are, you know, having your income come in. We don't trust that. We trust God to be our provider. We trust God to be our Jehovah Jireh, our provider. And so I just want to encourage you again, if you've never done this before, why don't you try it? You can do so by going to prayerhouse.uk/give, and a few clicks you can give online. And I just want to pray for those of us who are giving and those of you who are thinking about giving, just want to pray that God will bless you. So Father, I pray that you would bless these amazing men and women of God who are, Lord, sowing into your kingdom. And Father, I pray that this will truly be a seed that's being sown into your kingdom, Lord, and that this seed would grow and it will multiply. And Father, I pray that every single person who's been faithfully given, even during these tough days, Lord, I pray that they will reap the benefits in the kingdom fold, Father, not in ways that we might understand, but Father, in the kingdom, Father, in ways that you bless your people, multiples, Father, I pray that we'll have those blessings flowing into our lives. We ask, Lord, in Jesus' precious name, amen, amen. If you are someone who needs prayer for certain things, and or you need just help for something, you can get in touch by emailing us at prayforus. Use the number 4. So prayforus@prayerhouse.uk, and we can get in touch with you, or we can pray with you. You can also contact us using the phone number, the mobile number for the Prayer House. And call us or leave a message or a text. We're on WhatsApp as well. So use all of these forms to stay in touch, to connect, and let's be a cohesive church that works really well. Before we finish, I just want to talk to you guys about a new thing that we've introduced, we brought together, put together, and that is the prayer room. So on Sundays, from about 11:15 to roughly around till 12 o'clock, we have a prayer room. So you can find that at prayerhouse.uk, which is our website, /prayer room. Right, you go there and there's a link to a Zoom call. You can click on that link and you can then join a prayer room, which is on Zoom. And if you have anything that you want to pray about or need prayer for, there will be a team there who will be ready to receive you and pray with you. We even have ways of having private prayer rooms. So if there's something confidential, we'll put you in a separate room where it's private and we'll have a team with you. And you can pray for things that might be confidential as well. Now, as Paul mentioned, on Thursday this week, we had a prayer time at the New Step Road site for the prayer house, and we had a time of worshiping. Many of us were given the opportunity to pray out loud and to bless the church and the community. And this week, I'd like to encourage, if you missed the Thursday prayer time, this is a great moment where the prayer room is going to be open. And if you missed it on Thursday, why don't you head on there? It's prayerhouse.uk/prayer room. Go on there and let's get together. I'm going to be there, Kira's going to be there, and we're going to be praying together. This is live. This is actually going to happen now. So head on there and let's get together and pray together for the future of our church and our building and just our vision. And it'll be a great moment and a great time of praying. So if you missed Thursday, come on. And even if you didn't miss Thursday, you're still welcome to join us. So prayer room's open right now. So if you're interested, please do head on there. As we come to a close, here's an important thing I think which is worth picking up from Paul's sermon this morning. He said, in the end, it is the values that come out of the house that makes it beautiful. The Casa Bonita, the beautiful house, what makes it beautiful is the people and the values that come out of it that make it beautiful. So as we come to a close, I just want to read to you from Ephesians chapter 5, verse 1 and 2. It says, imitate God, therefore, in everything you do, because you are his children. Live a life filled with love, following the example of Christ. He loved us and offered himself as a sacrifice for us, a pleasing aroma to God. And so, Father, we thank you. We thank you, Lord, for all the things that you've done through us and in us. And we praise you. We praise you and we thank you for the site on Newstead Road and all the things that we were able to do there. But Father, as Paul reminded us, Lord, it's not the building, it's not the architecture, it's not the facilities and the way that it's built or anything like that that makes a house beautiful and pleasing to you. It's the people. It's us and the values that we carry in us and what comes out of us. And so Father, today I pray for every single one of us, Lord, that you would help us fulfill this word from Ephesians chapter 5. And that we'll be able to imitate you in everything that we do, because we are your children and we are your children, you as our Father. And God, help us to live a life filled with love, following the example of Christ. And God, help us, Lord, to be people who love one another sacrificially, that will jump to help others, Lord. We'll be excited to help others. That we'll be the first ones to ask the question, how can I help you? What can I do to make a difference in your life? And Father, that you would help us to nurture and to cultivate these values and to just shine it out through us with your help, through your Holy Spirit. And so I bless every single one of my friends who are watching this. Lord, we pray that your hand would rest on us and you'd be with us throughout the week till we get to do this again next week. So Father, we pray that you'd continue to work and bring to completion what you've already begun in us. In Jesus' precious name, I pray. Amen, 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 amen. God bless you. Have a great week and I'll see you again sometime very soon.